Hi there! At the end of our video, you'll find out how quadratic equations are solved using extracting the roots. But before that, let's define what is a quadratic equation. In algebra, a quadratic equation, from the Latin quadratus for square, is any equation having the form ax squared plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Remember that a quadratic equation in a standard form is equals to 0, where x represents an unknown, a, b, and c are real numbers. Here are some guides in finding how many possible solutions there is an equation. For the first one states that if c is greater than 0, then x squared equals to c has two solutions, where x squared is the quadratic term and c is the constant. For the second one states that if c is equals to 0, then x squared equals to c has one solution. For the last one states that if c is less than 0, then x squared equals to c has no real solution. So, what is extracting the roots? We use this kind of method to find the root that will satisfy the quadratic equation. But the question is, how do we do it? We need to make it into the form ax squared is equals to c, where ax squared is the quadratic term and c is the constant. Here are the steps in solving by extracting the roots. The first step is writing the equation in the form x squared is equals to c. The given equation is x squared minus 25 is equals to 0. When you say extracting the roots, we start by placing the quadratic term on the left side, and the constant on the right side. The sign of the constant will change from negative to positive. The next step is isolating the variable x. We need to isolate the variable x, and since both sides of the equation have perfect squares, we can extract the square roots. X is a perfect square which, when extracted, will become x. 25 is also a perfect square. Extracting it, we will get the number of 5. How did we get this? Recall the given guides a while ago. One of them states that if c is greater than 0 and it is not negative, then that means there are two possible solutions to this equation. The square root of 25 is positive negative 5. How did we get this? Positive multiply a positive number is a positive number. Positive number multiplied by a negative number vice versa will not produce a positive number, so that is rejected. Meanwhile, negative multiplied by a negative also produces a positive number. Therefore, this equation has two real solutions. To check if these values can satisfy the equation, we need to substitute both of it in the original equation, which is x squared minus 25 is equals to 0. So, for x equals to 5, substitute from the original equation, x squared minus 25 is equals to 0, 5 squared minus 25 is equals to 0, 25 minus 25 is equals to 0, 0 is equals to 0, it means that it satisfies the equation. For the next one, for x is equals to negative 5, x squared minus 25 is equals to 0, negative 5 squared minus 25 is equals to 0, 25 minus 25 is equals to 0, 0 is equals to 0, it means that it satisfies the equation. Both values can satisfy the equation, so it means that positive 5 and negative 5 are indeed roots of this equation. The given example is 5x squared is equals to 500. We need to isolate the quadratic term, so we have to remove its coefficient, which is 5. In order to remove it, we have to divide both sides by 5. After simplifying it, we now need to get the square root of both of this equation. The square root of x squared is x. And the square root of 100 is 10. Since 100 is greater than 0, it answers that it has two possible solutions, positive and negative 10. For example number 3, t squared is equals to 0, then get its square root 5, then help t is equal to 0. Check it. T is equal to 0, substitute from the original equation, which is t squared is equal to 0. 0 squared is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0, means that it satisfies the equation. And it only have one solution. Example number 4. The given quadratic equation is x squared is equal to negative 9. When you extract both of its square roots, you'll find that negative 9 cannot have its square roots extracted. The square root of negative 9 is 3i, with a symbolizing that is only imaginary. I said that when x squared is equal to less than 0, there will be no real roots. Since negative 9 is less than 0, this equation has no real roots. Now let's proceed to the last example. We need to find the solutions of the equation quantity x minus 4 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. First, we must notice that isn't in the standard form. So in order to come up with that form, we need to perform ABE, additional property of equality. So we need to transfer negative 25 to the right side. So in order to come up with that, we need to add positive 25 to both sides. Then it would be quantity x minus 4 squared is equal to 25. And get the square root of it. Square root of quantity x minus 4 squared is equal to square root of 25. Solve the remaining equation. Transfer negative 4 to the right side. Value of x, which is positive 5. X is equal to 4 plus 5. X is equal to 9. The second value of x is negative 5. So x is equal to negative 5 plus 4. X is equal to negative 1. Let's proceed to the checking. So substitute the solutions to the original equation, which is quantity x minus 4 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. Our value of x is equal to positive 9, negative 1. For positive 9, quantity x minus 4 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. 9 minus 4 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. 5 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. 25 minus 25 is equal to 0. Is equal to 0, it means that it satisfies the equation. Quantity x minus 4 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. Negative 1 is minus 4 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. Negative 5 squared minus 25 is equal to 0. 25 minus 25 is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0, means that it satisfies the equation. So that's how the method extracting the roots is done. Did you like this video? Was it helpful? If so, give this video a thumbs up and share with your friends. Subscribe to this channel for more awesome presentation like this. And hit that bell so that you can be instantly notified whenever I post a new video. Thanks for watching!